Hey Branches Kids, it's Miss Jasmine here. So today I'm going to read you guys just a little book about a baseball player. Not just any baseball player, but the first African-American baseball player in the major leagues. Now, let's start reading. I Am Jackie Robinson by Brad Meltzer and illustrated by Christopher Ilopons. I Am Jackie Robinson. Sometimes it's hard to be brave. My mother was brave, and she liked brave people. When I was born, the youngest of five kids, she even named me after someone brave. His middle name would be Roosevelt, Jack Roosevelt Robinson. Why Roosevelt? After President Teddy Roosevelt, he fought to make sure black people were treated the same as everyone else. You'll see, I'm not worried. That's a lot for little Jackie to live up to. But having a brave name doesn't make you a brave person. In fact, as a kid, I didn't like sleeping alone. I used to sleep in my mom's bed. Even when she tried to bribe me, I wouldn't leave. I'll give you a quarter to go sleep in your room. Not a chance. It's better here. One of the scariest moments came when I was 8 years old. I was outside, and a girl from across the street called me a terrible name. I was so mad, I yelled a name right back at her. Her father came running immediately. He didn't like it that a black boy was standing up to his white daughter. You were the only black family on our block. What you call her? She started it. I don't remember who threw the first rock, but the fight was on. Me versus her dad. Get him, dad! I had a good arm, but no one wins in a rock fight. Eventually, the girl's mother came out and broke it up. Like I said, the world can be a scary place, but even a kid like me, there was one thing that always made me happy. Sports and winning at sports. Okay, that's two things. I loved playing everything. Baseball, football, basketball, soccer, marbles, even dodgeball. All the kids would get in a circle, white, black, Hispanic, Asian. We all played together. The rules were simple. If the ball hits you, you were out. I'd duck, jump, leap, and of course throw, and throw, and throw. By the time I was done, I'd be the last one standing. Are they mad that I won? Don't know. Fall down. Maybe they won't notice. But the truth was, they weren't mad at me for winning. They appreciated the skill it took. Those childhood games were some of the only times I wasn't judged by the color of my skin. Hooray, Jackie! How's he do it? And what's the B on his hat stand for? You'll see. Still, that didn't make all my problems go away. At the local public pool in Brookside Park, you could only go swimming if you were white. If your skin was black, they locked you out. When people complained, they gave us one day each week, Wednesday. Every Wednesday from 2 to 5 p.m., they opened the pool to anybody, black, Mexican, or Asian. Don't they know how hot it is out here? Trust me, they know. Don't they know how mean that is? Trust me, they know. Oh, come on, he even swims in his hat. Maybe the B is for boya. So, how do you win when you feel like you're fighting the entire world? My mother, who worked as a maid, showed me the answer. Back then, we were so poor, we sometimes ate only two meals a day. To help us out, every Saturday night, the local bakery would let us take their leftovers. And the milkman, back when your milk was delivered to your house, would give us whatever extra he had. It's a feast. Look at all this food. What I mean, it's not just for us. We weren't the only ones struggling for money. My mom took the extra food and shared it with all our neighbors. That's right, she even shared it with the angry guy who threw rocks at me. Would you like some extra bread? Wow, thanks. That's very kind of you. I'm Mally, Jackie's mom. Nice to meet you, Mally. That's how we got to be friends with everyone in the neighborhood. This was one of my mom's best lessons. When you do something good, it brings out the good in others. Plus, the more our neighbors got to know us, the more they realized just how much black and white people were alike. I learned a similar lesson from a local mechanic named Carl Anderson. He saw the group of boys I used to hang out with. We called ourselves the Pepper Street Gang. We were a bunch of poor kids. For fun, we'd throw dirt clods at cards and swipe golf balls from the local course. Then he saw what we were doing. Mr. Anderson took me aside. He didn't lose his temper. Calm as could be, he told me, "Jackie, I know why you're following the crowd. You're afraid they'll think you're different or chicken, but it doesn't take gut to follow the crowd. Courage comes from being willing to be different." When Mr. Anderson said that day, it got to me. With the help of my pastor, I stopped hanging around with that gang. From there, I threw myself even deeper into my favorite activity. Sports, and winning at sports, especially baseball. As a teenager, I could run so fast, a local reporter noticed that in nearly every game I stole second, third, and home at least once. "That isn't a steal. It's grand lardacy. Man, this guy can write. You were just on first base. How'd you get so fast?" Maybe the beat is for blast off. In college, I became the first UCLA student ever to letter in four sports in the same season: baseball, and football, and basketball, and track. They said I was one of the best football players in the country. Two seasons in a row, I scored the most points of any player in the league. I won the NCAA title that year. Only one American jumped further than me. But the same problems kept coming back. When the college newspaper wrote a nice article about me, one of my own white teammates purposely smashed into my leg, trying to injure me. He was mad that the article said something nice about a black person. "Don't they know we're all the same team?" Trust me, they know. Ah, my leg. By the time I got out of the army, it still didn't matter that I was one of the best athletes in the country. If you wanted to play professional sports, you had to be white. Sorry, son, your kind doesn't belong here. Back then, if you were the world champ, it meant you were the white champs. In all of Major League Baseball, not a single team had one black player. Oh, and did I mention that if you were on a black team, the pay was worse, the food was worse, and sometimes the only place to sleep was on the bus? Gross. Is this food or goo? You don't want to know. But that was all about to change. Thanks to a man named Branch Rickey. Rickey was the president of Brooklyn Dodgers, one of the most popular baseball teams ever. I have an idea. The Dodgers were secretly looking at black players. "Are you nuts? People will start rooting for us. It's time to do what's right." With so many players fighting in the World War II, Rickey had a plan for filling this team. After searching all across the United States and the world, Branch Rickey found me. "I'm Jackie Robinson. Nice to meet you." "Nice to meet you too. I think you can play in the major leagues.
How do you feel about that? Mr. Ricky told me that he knew I was a good ball player, but he wanted to know whether I had the guts. He warned me that many white people would be mad to see a black player. There's no one on our side, no owners, no umpires. Loads of players and spectators will yell at you. Pitchers will throw baseballs to your head, but no worries. What they do, if you get angry, it'll look like you can't handle it. Can you handle it? On April 18th, 1946, at 27 years old, I was given my shot. At Roosevelt Stadium in Jersey City, New Jersey, I played my first official game for the Montreal Royals, the Brooklyn Dodgers farm team. You better believe I was terrified. I didn't want to let people down. Then, at 3:04 p.m. in my first at-bat, I was thrown out at first. You're out. Thousands of black spectators had come to see what I could do. Thousands of white people were there too, convinced that a black player couldn't possibly be as good as a white one. It was up to me to prove them wrong. The next time I came up was in the third inning. There was two men on base. The pitcher decided on a fastball. I can see it coming, chest high, down the middle, but this time, crack! When the ball finally landed 340 feet away in the left field stand, no one could say that the black man can't play as well as a white man. Some call it a home run. Others call it history. That afternoon, in five at-bats, I hit and got on base four times. I stole second twice and scored four runs. Hooray, Jackie! How's he doing it? When he puts the B hat on, it's gonna be for boom. When the game was done, I couldn't get to the locker room because I was so mobbed by fans. White, black, young, old, even the folks rooting for the other team, they were cheering for me. Still, that didn't mean it was easy. When I started playing for the Brooklyn Dodgers, lots of players didn't want me there. Pitchers threw fastballs at my head. Runners stepped on me with their cleats. Catchers even spit on my shoes, and they weren't just coming after me. They told me that if I kept playing, they'll hurt my son. Was I mad? Yes. Was I scared? Yes. I know you saw that. But I never let it stop. Crack! I told you the B is for boom, and the B is for Brooklyn genius. Game after game, I kept playing, knowing I wasn't just playing for myself. Every time, more and more people, black and white, were cheering. In the stands, fans wore "I'm for Jackie" buttons. And slowly, eventually, we were all playing together. Black, white, Asian, Hispanic. Baseball opened up to everyone. It was just like those childhood games of dodgeball. Through the simple game of baseball, the country saw a new possibility, a new option. All they needed was for someone to go first. In life, people tried to scare me. They wanted to stop me. They wanted to make me go away. Why? Because I was different. Every time I wanted to fight back, but for real change to come, you need to lead by example. Being a leader takes bravery. But remember this, no one is born brave. No matter how big or small you are, there will always be things that scare you. It's okay to be afraid. Just don't let it stop you. Remember that park where they wouldn't let him swim? It's now called Robinson Park. Today, no one in baseball can wear the number 42. But once a year, every player on every team wears it. It's that one day when everyone looks the same. There is a real power in each and every one of us. Use that power to do what's right. Use the power for a cause that you believe in. And most of all, use the power to lead and help others. You'll know, understand, of Brooklyn, you would have told people the B was for brave. Just like my middle name. I am Jackie Robinson. I will always lead the way and hope you will too. When others see your example, they'll stand with you. It's the only way the world ever gets changed. Together. Here are just some facts about Jackie Robinson. So, just to sum up the story, Jackie Robinson was the first Black Major League Baseball player. And to this day, he just wanted people to express themselves no matter what color skin they was. And it's okay to be different. Hey, Branches family. If you're here, that means you have already read the book for Jackie Robinson. If you haven't read the book, make sure you read the book before coming into the activity. So now we're in part two of Jackie Robinson. So today we're going to do a little activity based on Jackie Robinson. We're going to do a little drawing of him. So you're going to need some paper, you're going to need some glue stick, and you're going to need some crayons if you only have white paper. If you have coloring sheet paper, then you just made it easier for yourself. So go ahead and get all your supplies. So our first step of making our Jackie Robinson picture, you're gonna take a sheet of paper and we're gonna make his head. So you're gonna fold it in half, you're gonna fold it hamburger style, and then you're gonna use a scissor and you're gonna make sure that you cut a circle just like this. Once you have cut your sheet of paper, you're gonna open it and you're gonna cut it in half. You're going to color them. So for one, it doesn't matter which one, you're gonna color one brown and you're gonna color the other one blue. Now, after coloring the two halves, brown and blue, you're gonna cut out the rest of the parts of Jackie Robinson. Jackie Robinson needs eyes, a mouth, his bat, his baseball, and the final touch of the hat. And he also needs that little lucky B on his hat. So once you have all your pieces together, you wanna make sure you have the eyes, the mouth, the little special part of the hat, the bat, the baseball, the special B, and the two halves that you had to color earlier. We're gonna glue them all together. After gluing the face and the hat, now we're gonna glue the eyes and the mouth. Ready? There you go. Now, after doing that, we're gonna put the little piece of the hat on. After putting the little piece of the hat, we're gonna put the B for brave. Now, remember when I told you you needed something blue to write with? We're gonna make his Dodgers shirt. Now, we're just gonna do a little curve as if it was an actual t-shirt. Once you make the t-shirt, you're gonna write Dodgers. After we're done making the t-shirt and writing the word Dodgers, we're gonna glue the baseball in this corner and the baseball in that corner. And there you go, you have yourself a Jackie Robinson drawing. I'm so glad that you guys got to do a Jackie Robinson cutout with me. Now, a little message is don't ever judge anybody by the color of their skin. Also, remember, everyone is unique. Remember that you came in your own way. I can't wait to see you guys next time.
Thanks for watching. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on all of our social media. See you next time. Bye.